Wouldn't it be cool if there was a unified set of APIs that you could use in any desktop app? Turns out there is. It's called Project Reunion, and that's what we're going to talk about on today's Visual Studio Toolbox. Hi, welcome to Visual Studio Toolbox. I'm the guest host, Robert Green, filling in for Leslie today, and I'm very excited to be with my good friend, Mr. Andrew Clinick of the Windows team. Hey, Andrew.
Hey, Robert, long time no see.
I know. Andrew and I have known each other a long time, dating back to the Visual Studio Tools for Office days. It's really
Oh,
good to
that's the
see you.
book. It's right there. Look.
Yes,
Love
the
that.
book. Right on. Today, we're going to talk about Project Reunion, which is very, very exciting, and it's going to kind of make sense of the current state of Windows development. I guess that's kind of a broad overview. But what exactly is Project Reunion, and who's it aimed at, and how does it help them?
Yeah, it's a great question. So, when we started building Project Reunion, it was really about enabling people to build great Windows apps. And I think one of the things we've learned in the last year is how important a PC is to everyday productivity for pretty much all of us. I know about you, I feel like I'm sat in front of the screen
Yep.
24/7, not
The
quite
desktop is
24/7.
not going away.
Yeah. And, increasingly we're seeing people asking for better experiences. And, we love the web. The web's awesome. But, having native experiences that can really deliver, great experiences, maybe it's your line of business. Certainly my kids are spending quality time on their PC doing homework, I'm sure. But if homework involves Among Us or Roblox or whatever, but building those applications, and of course web browsers have to be built too, on the native platform is so important to deliver such a great experience. And Reunion is about enabling all Windows developers to build a better Windows experience. We want your customers to get a better experience. We want you to get a better experience as a developer, and making it easier for you to develop those apps.
So we know that WinForms and WPF now support .NET 5. And we've had a number of episodes about that on Channel 9. People have talked about it. So, all of the new advancements in .NET and the languages come to WinForms and WPF, which is awesome. So that's from kind of the .NET runtime side. But what was missing on the Windows side? Because you always get the new Windows, who's right?
We always got the new Windows, and of course we see the uptake of Windows 10. It's going up, and that's awesome. But one of the things, the feedback we got from talking to customers was like, look, I want to write an app that addresses all my users, no matter what version of Windows they're on. And how can we, and right now, we are introducing some cool new tech and newer versions of the Windows, but you couldn't write an app that took advantage of that. Or so you had to choose, and you had to wait till your users got there, which could take a while. So Reunion's goal is to bring those platform features to you and decouple them from the OS so that your application can use them. Now, actually, I have a handy little diagram that can show
And is
you.
this UI? Is this APIs? Is it both?
Yeah, no, that's and it's really the entirety of what your application wants to run. So, today on project, I have desktop apps, I have UWP applications, and those apps, be it a WPF or a WinForms app on the left-hand side, calls desktop APIs, and the UWP app can call UWP APIs, and to a certain extent they can mix and match, but it was kind of confusing. So, and when you build an application, we always think about the UI, and obviously the UI is kind of the thing that we see the most. But oftentimes when we talk to developers, they tell us is like, look, the UI code is maybe 20, 30% of my app. A lot of my app is actually, making that stuff work, and providing all that. So we want to ensure that we bring all those APIs available to you, the UI, but also the platform APIs. So Project Reunion goal is to bring those desktop APIs, bring them up, and decouple them from the OS, so they will be able to de your app will be able to be deployed to older versions of Windows 10.
Yeah, okay.
And likewise, bring a lot of those UWP APIs. So the developers don't have to choose. It's like, well, I started one project. Now I can call these APIs. But if I'd started it a different way, so whether you're a WPF developer, WinForm, .NET, C++, heck, Rust, JavaScript, we want you to be able to use all of those APIs.
Okay. So
that's the goal, is to, and that's why we call it reunion, is to unify that. So we have the standard Windows apps and libraries can utilize all of those APIs.
So my app is not going to literally depend on a particular release of Windows unless I specifically need it to, right?
Absolutely. So the goal is you'll be able to write great apps that work everywhere. Mm-hmm. But if you're in a newer version, then of course you can light up and call some cool new APIs. Like, for example, you might want to use Windows Hello, which isn't necessarily available on everybody's machine even. Even if they all have the same version, you might not have a cool camera that enables that. So utilize that and light up and make your application better in places where it's available.
That's cool. So Windows goes back to being the operating system, and the APIs you call as part of apps ship, I guess, as a NuGet package, right?
That's right. As a NuGet package and a framework package. Funny.
That is flipping cool.
We have framework packages that actually deliver. So if I have my application, I'm deploying it to your machine. Well, your machine might not have the reunion APIs. So we have these framework packages, which actually we've had since Windows 8.1. But reunion enables all Windows apps, whether they're deployed via MSAX, set up to XE, X copy off a USB key or a floppy disk. We don't care. And when you run your application, we'll pull down the framework packages for you. Now, of course, enterprises can deploy those ahead of time. They can do all those types of things. But it gets deployed once on your machine, and then you get to update, and then all in the applications get to take advantage of that, and we can keep that up to date for you, and you get to control how quickly you update.
So, and whether you're writing a desktop app using WinForms or WPF, or you're writing a UWP app, you can just call these APIs, and you could also, you know, I guess this opens up the ability to create class libraries of common functionality that can just be called by any client running on any version of Windows.
Absolutely. And in fact, we just released 0.5 on March 29th, so just a couple weeks ago. And a lot of the UI control vendors, they simultaneously shipped with us. Simultaneous is difficult for a British person to say, but in terms of, you look at Telerik, you look at Uno. Uno's doing some really cool stuff cross-platform. Yep. Apologies if I forget the other folks, but there's a bunch of the control vendors, which are in essence libraries, as you pointed out, are available already today, so that you can utilize that.
So they could write one set of controls that are then available regardless of what your Windows front end is written in, basically.
Yeah. And the notion is you pick and choose the tech that you want. Look, if you love WinForms WPF, great, that's awesome. But like, for example, we're introducing a new way to activate your application so you can be more battery efficient. Mm-hmm. You can use that and not have to redo all your UI in order to use those features.
Right.
Of course, you can use WinUI 3, which is a core part of reunion, and you can utilize that. We'd love it if you did. And we WinUI is really where we're kind of focusing our investments in the UI space on Windows. But it's not required. And likewise, MSAX is how we're focusing on investments for deploying apps. But again, you don't have to do that. We believe WinUI and MSAX are the best ways to go do it. But we also realize that your existing app is probably the best way for your customers to utilize that.
Does Project Reunion rely on .NET 5?
It doesn't. Good question. So it fully supports .NET 5, but you can use C++. You can be completely bare metal if you want to. You can use Rust. We're working with React Native and lots of folks in order to go do that. In that we don't want to require you to use a specific version. Clearly, we love .NET 5. That's awesome.
Right.
Most of our demos and frankly most of our customers right now are using that, and that's great. But you can mix and match. Of course, you can use C++ if you want to, really ensuring that you can go do that. And we did a bunch of work with some new Win32 metadata to make it just a whole bunch easier to get at those APIs.
And then what role does WinUI play in all this? And so what is WinUI and what role does WinUI play?
Yeah, that's a great question. So I have a slide.
Right. All great questions can be answered with a slide. Yeah. Right?
Well, in terms of, we think of like four things that we're investing in. You know, we're starting with the UX, and WinUI 3 is a major part of that. Clearly, WinUI 3 just shipped with 0.5 last month, and we're doing two more kind of big updates this year. But also, WinUI 3 brings WebView 2 from Edge, so you can use Chromium inside of your app in a lot more efficient way and using a lot less memory if you want to. But we're also investing in making windowing better, something which we get a lot of feedback on. And then the other end of the spectrum is like, how on earth do I actually deploy my apps? So MSX, which is our deployment tech, if you want to use that, clearly we're fans of that. But the framework packages, you can take advantage of those irrespective of how you deploy it. And then in the middle, thinking about things like ARM64 support, super important in order to be able to do that. But taking advantage of inking and input, optimizing for the device hardware, which includes Windows Hello. The camera that I'm using on my PC is a Windows Hello camera as well, which is awesome. Take advantage of that. But then thinking about system performance and battery life. Now, I hope to worry about battery life at some point when I travel outside of my house. But right now, being a power efficient app is super important too. In terms of, how can we reduce our impact on the environment, but also, frankly, reduce the impact on my electricity bill that I'm now paying for five of us in my house who are all working from home, right?
Exactly.
So how can we be more efficient and take advantage of that? So WinUI is a key part of this, though.
And is WinUI a replacement for UWP? Is it the next flavor of XAML that I get to learn?
The question I was hoping you weren't going to ask me. is bringing the UI stack that you saw in UWP that lots of folks were using, and just making that available to all Windows apps, so that our focus for this year is fundamentally on building great desktop apps.
Mm-hmm.
And that's not to say that Xbox and HoloLens aren't important. Obviously they are, but like focusing on desktop in terms of that's our, where we see most of our development going on right now.
Yeah.
And bringing that, so bringing the capabilities from UWP to all Windows apps. So WinUI 3, MSX is a core part of that. And the activation, the application lifecycle and notifications. Again, enabling every Windows app to utilize those if they want to.
Right. So Project Reunion is it a replacement for, or is it the next version of XAML Islands, which was the ability to take UWP XAML and put it in a WPF or WinForms app?
Yeah, so XAML Islands are really cool. It allows you to mix and match. In 0.5 of WinUI that we have right now, we don't have XAML Island support. Okay. That's something which we're working with the community on GitHub. One of the things we're doing with Reunion is doing all of our planning, all our speccing, and out in the public on GitHub, and that's a very commonly requested feature. So we're finalizing our plans for that, for fingers crossed, for later this year.
Okay, cool.
So, yeah.
And so WinUI 3 is at 0.5 right now, and is there...
Yeah, when, so...
When's it going to release for real?
So we have a... Funny enough, I have another slide for that, too. So we have three releases this year that we're planning. So 0.5, and the reason why we've gone with we often get asked why is it 0 dot and why is it not just 1, is that we're evolving this over time and we're working with the community. And that frankly, there's going to be some things that we do that maybe people don't like, and we'll adjust on that. So it's kind of joining us on the journey. For many people, that will be, look, you know, 1.0 is probably when they'll take advantage of that. But we're doing released versions. The 0.5 and 0.8 will be fully supported, so you'll be able to take advantage of that and ship on your apps. And then you'll be able to take advantage of these as they're going forward. So it is a little confusing. I think that's, you know, mea culpa to a certain extent. It's like, well, hold on, Win UI 3 and Project Reunion 0.5, what's going on?
Yeah.
And we felt it was important not to kind of move people's cheese, essentially. It was like, you know, people were, if you're following Win UI, then you expected to be 3.0. It would be kind of weird if we said, well, this is Win UI 0.5. And they're like, well, hold on, we've had 1 and 2.
Exactly.
So, and each one of those technologies are part of the reunion family. So the family has a version numbering. And as we progress over time, then, you know, one hopes that we'll catch up, right? But we don't want to force a versioning scheme on everybody.
Yeah.
Just to be part of reunion.
So fall is about the same time that .NET 6 arrives. So it's going to be pretty exciting end of the year around here.
Yeah. So, I mean, we have much love for our .NET family. So, you know, fall is also in the northwest of the U.S. a fairly long event. So we'll see. Our goal is to try and think as much as we can.
Yeah.
Spring is exceptionally long in the northwest. So
exactly.
Yeah.
Well, you know, in Seattle there's basically two seasons, rain and not. So
right.
Rainy season is long. Yeah. So yeah. It makes sense.
Yes. So you know, it helps focus the mind. Right. So
okay. So this has been an excellent overview. You know what I think we should do, if you're up for it, I think we should follow this up with one of our hour-long Visual Studio Toolbox live episodes, where we can dive into more details, we can do some demos, we can talk about specific scenarios and answer lots of questions.
Yeah, absolutely. We'd love to do that. You know,
all right. So
great to be with you and with our customers. We'll
plan that sometime in the near future.
I'm not going anywhere.
Me either.
Yeah, right. So.
All right. That's cool. Thanks so much for coming on the show, Andrew. This is a great overview of what Reunion is. There was a blog post that you did. We'll put that link to that in the show notes. Send me any other links you want added.
Yeah, and really, is like, give us feedback. Try it out. We know it's not perfect right now, but we would love to get your feedback. And that's really what we're pushing on right now. And you know, we're trying to keep up to date with that daily, so that, you know, and publishing our roadmap. And so on our Project Reunion GitHub site is the key place to keep up to date.
Cool.
All right.
Thanks again. Hope you guys enjoyed that. And we will see you next time on Visual Studio Toolbox.